Excellencies, distinguished colleagues, good morning and good afternoon to everyone joining this virtual gathering. Firstly, allow me to thank the Group of 24 and the Alliance for Financial Inclusion for having me join this vital conversation. I want to also take this opportunity to commend you on the important work done so far towards the Youth Financial Inclusion Policy Framework as a tool to support policymakers worldwide in the financial and economic inclusion of young people. Today's world is home to the largest population of young people in the history, 1.8 billion, with close to 90% of them living in developing countries. The increasing number of young people worldwide constitute a tremendous asset and potential to be tapped into. But that will be possible only if the right investments are made and opportunities are provided for all of them to thrive and fulfill their aspirations. Today's generation of young people are more dynamic, engaged, and interconnected than ever. They have shown an extraordinary resilience, action, and leadership despite the challenges faced. For an example, even before the COVID-19 pandemic overturned our lives and aspirations, over 1 in 5 young people were neither in employment, education, or training. 132 million young girls were out of school worldwide. Almost half of the people financially excluded around the world were young people. And it's estimated that 408 million young people today live in contexts affected by armed conflict and violence. According to the International Labour Organization, youth unemployment rates were about 3 times higher than that of adults before the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. Furthermore, unemployment rates are rising both at a faster pace and to a more considerable degree for young people than adults. And in young women, in particular, are the most impacted. Even when employed, around 126 million or 30% of youth engaged in employment live in extreme or moderate poverty despite having a job. Thus, many young people resort to self-employment and entrepreneurship to make a living. In fact, youth make up the largest proportion of the people in the informal job market, with more than 75% of the world's young people engaged in informal jobs. This by itself makes youth exceptionally vulnerable to economic shocks and excluded from the COVID-19 crisis-related short-term financial assistance programs for businesses. Young entrepreneurs need to be encouraged and supported by governments, educational institutions, and financial system in order to succeed. With increased market access for young people, innovative policies and regulatory frameworks, and more flexible financing arrangements. Financial inclusion is a crucial enabler for many young people to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. It's also vital in ensuring individuals' resilience against economic shocks, such as the COVID-19 pandemic. However, almost half of the young people worldwide do not have a basic bank account at a formal financial institution, with the vast majority of them living in developing countries. Economic, social, cultural, gender, and religious factors may also affect the availability and accessibility of financial products for youth. For instance, 84% of young people in high-income countries are financially included, compared with fewer than 40% in sub-Saharan Africa, the Middle East and North Africa, Latin America, the Caribbean, according to the Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development. It's becoming increasingly clear that the socioeconomic impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic will continue to affect young people for years to come. Millennials who have not yet recovered from the previous financial crises and the challenging job markets are now facing a second wave of hardship. At the same time, Generation Z steps into a very uncertain future with the current unemployment rates. The economic downturn, rising inequalities, and the school closures worldwide contribute to this further. The only way to address these issues is to build back better in the 10 years we have left to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. Both the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development and the Addis Ababa Action Agenda serves as blueprints for a fair and sustainable transition for post-COVID-19 recovery. They recognize that investing in youth is critical to achieving inclusive, equitable, and sustainable development for present and future generation. With these, we need to creative solutions to ensure that our recovery efforts put young people front and center and ensure realization of their human rights, leaving no one behind. Therefore, with the onset of the pandemic, we have worked together with partners, with member states and young people to discuss critical areas for financing development in the era of COVID-19 and beyond. I want to highlight some of these areas that I feel need to be brought forward to the discussions today. First, the need for fairer, more equal societies, especially for women and girls, people living with disabilities, LGBTIQ+ youth, and marginalized and crisis-affected groups. Secondly, we should focus on open, inclusive, affordable, and secure access to digital technologies. Third, improving data availability for informed decision-making and accountability is a necessity. Fourth, governments are encouraged to create an enabling environment to support the growth of youth enterprises. And finally, I want to emphasize that in line with the UN's Youth Strategy, Youth 2030, governments should aim to accelerate the creation of youth-enabling employment and self-employment ecosystems and develop and operationalize strategies that prioritize the improvement of both the quantity and quality of jobs for young people. We need to ensure that young people have access to integrated and adequate services and productive resources, including finance, digital, and other technology-related resources, both in rural and urban areas. Let's commit to support young people's incredible resilience, courage, commitment, and leadership in the fight against COVID-19 in their communities and in addressing the existing systemic inequalities, climate crisis, social injustice, power imbalance, conflicts that have exacerbated by this pandemic. Young people remain hopeful and engaged as they dare to believe a better world is possible. We, as leaders and decision makers of today, owe it to the young people to create an enabling environment that ensures every young person is empowered to achieve their fullest potential. I look forward to the outcomes and recommendations from this roundtable. Thank you.